In this GIMP workshop, we are going to create a low-poly portrait in black and white. If you want to use the same image as in the tutorial, you can find the download link in the description. Because we will work directly on the original image, it might be a good idea to first make a copy in case something goes wrong. Now right-click on the photo and click Open with GIMP. We will work with the black and white image, but we can apply this very same technique in exactly the same way on a color photo. The key to creating a recognizable low poly image is to add more detail in the important areas, such as the eyes, nose and mouth, and to use larger polygon shapes in the less important areas. And it's also important to follow the lighter or darker areas in the original to get depth in our low poly image. Hit the Z key on your keyboard to activate the zoom tool and select an area around one of the eyes. Now we activate the free select tool by hitting the F key on our keyboard. Then we make the first triangle. Just click once where you want to start and then click again at every corner until you get back to where you started. Then click in the first yellow dot to make the selection complete. Activate the color picker by pressing the O key on your keyboard. Go to the tool options and check Sample Average. Make it size 5. Then check Set Background Color. Go ahead and click in the triangle to select the gray color. When we left click and hold, we can see a square that indicates from which area we are making a color sample. Had we made the radius from the sample average higher or lower, this square would be bigger or smaller. We can, by drag and drop, also move this square anywhere in our image to select a color. The background color in the foreground background indicator changes accordingly. All this can help us pick the gray color we want to use. Now, when we have found our color, we let go of the mouse and we hit Ctrl X. And there it is, our first triangle, filled with gray color. Hit shortcut F, so the free select tool is active again, and make the next triangle. Be careful not to leave blank spaces between the triangles. To be safe, it's best to overlap them slightly. When we hold the Alt key, we can move by click and drag the whole selection. If necessary, we can also make a new polygon shape just on top of a previous one. Now we hit O on our keyboard to activate the color picker again. After that, we select the color by clicking the left mouse button. No need to hold it down now. Then we hit Ctrl X to fill the selection. And there it is, our second triangle. Hit the F key to activate the free select tool again. Make the third selection. When we hit and hold the spacebar, the cursor changes into the Move tool, and we can, by moving the mouse without clicking, move the image. By pressing the Ctrl key and simultaneously turning the mouse wheel, we can zoom in or out. Hit O. Click to select the gray color. And hit Ctrl X to fill the selection. And back to the free select tool by pressing F. Now make the next selection. And that is how it works. Because this process can take some time, you might want to export your work at some point. We can do this by going to File, and there we click Overwrite. Or we click Export As, and save it under a new name. Then we can continue later where we left off now. But don't forget to set the tool options of the color picker again as in the previous session. For the sake of the tutorial, we will go fast forward. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks very much for watching.